Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to discuss the new lesson of political science, that is federalism. Federalism is very exciting and very important lesson to know the basic structure of the Indian democratic setup, because federal idea are very essential and they are very beneficial to the citizens of the country. If government decided to work under the federal system, then these have many benefits and advantage to the democratic setup of the country. That is why federalism is very essential and very important lesson, okay, to know what are the democratic ideas and how government works in different field, okay, by giving equal justice and other important basic ideals to the citizens of the country. That is why federalism is important lesson. So let us start with the definition of this federalism. Federalism definition is that it is the system of government in which central authority share its power to various constituent units of the country. Central authority share its power to various constituent units of the country. This is known as federalism. It means what? Simply, when central government share its power to various levels of government, such as state governments or local government, okay, and increase the unity of the country, this is called federalism. Because federalism reduces the burden of central government, okay, and it also makes the central government very efficient to work independently. That is why federal ideas or federalism is quite possible and quite stable for democratic setup. So this is when central authority share its power to various constituent units of the country and hold the country. This is known as federalism. So this federalism has been originated from undivided political power. You might have already studied in standard 9th or 8th that in before the democratic setup in the world, there were many countries who did not share power to all levels of government, but most of the time central government alone captured the entire power of the country and it started working over the people. That is why the central government decided now in the course of changing time, okay, it is decided to share its power to various levels of government for smooth functioning and for smooth working. Okay, that is why this federal ideas has emerged, okay, from undivided political power in various countries of the world. Dear students, after this definition of the federalism, let us discuss the features of federalism. So what are the features of federalism? Features of federalism. There are many features of federalism. Number one, two or more levels of government. Two or more levels of government. Keep in mind, federal country always has two or more levels of government. On the basis of this characteristic or feature, okay, can you tell me, is India a federal country? Yes, India is a federal country because in India there are two or more levels of government, such as central, then state government, then local government. So we have three levels of government in the country. Therefore, India is called a federal country. Okay, any federal country in the world, they have two or more levels of government. Keep in mind. So this is a very important feature of federalism. Second feature of federalism is that federal countries have separate jurisdiction. Means whichever federal countries are working in the world, okay, they have separate jurisdiction. Jurisdiction means judiciary. It is known as judiciary. That is court system. Okay, it is known as court system. India also has separate jurisdictions or judiciary for each level of government. For example, listen, for central level there is supreme court, okay. Then for state level there are high courts, okay, and for local level there are district courts. So this is separate jurisdiction or a separate court system are specified for each level of government. For central level, Supreme Court is there. For state government, high courts are there. And for local government, district courts are there. So this is called separate jurisdiction. I hope you have understood this particular part and main feature of the Indian federalism. So, and separate jurisdiction for each level of government is specified in the constitution. Third, separate jurisdiction is specified in the constitution. In the constitution for each level, okay, separate jurisdiction, that is area of court, is specified in the constitution for each level of government. So this is also third important feature of federalism. Fourth one, fundamental provisions cannot be changed by one level of government unilaterally, but it requires consent from both level of government. You might be knowing, students, that our constitution has two phases. One phase is rigid and second phase is flexible. Rigid means what? The basic structure or the fundamental provisions of the constitution cannot be changed by one level of government, that is central. Basic structure or the fundamental provisions of the constitution cannot be changed by one level of government, that is central government. Okay, but to change the basic structure of the constitution, it requires consent from both the level of government, central as well as state government. Okay, for example, in central level, two-third majority of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, okay, as well as two-third majority of all the state governments in the country, this type of majority is required to change the fundamental provisions of the constitution. Otherwise, it is very difficult. But when constitution came into force, in 1950, from 1950 till date, that is 2021, it is quite difficult for the government of India to change the fundamental provisions of the constitution. That is why in this particular case, our constitution is rigid. Rigid means cannot be touched at all, cannot be changed at all. But on the other hand, if you see that many old and outdated provisions of the constitution or some rules and regulations are not suitable according to the changing time, okay, such rules and regulations or laws, okay, were replaced and introduced new ones, okay, or they were modified. This flexibility in the constitution has been decided by the framers of the constitution. That is why in this case our constitution is flexible. Till today's date, there are more than 100 constitution amendments took place, okay, where constitution is flexible. So in this way, keep in mind, students, fundamental provisions of the constitution cannot be changed by one level of government unilaterally. Unilaterally means single. It requires consent from both level of government, that is central and state government. So this is one of the important feature. Then fifth one, courts have powers to interpret the constitution. courts have power to interpret the constitution, means Supreme Court and High Courts, only these two courts, okay, Supreme Courts and High Courts, only these two courts have powers to interpret the constitution to the government. Interpret means what? To explain the meaning of the law to the government. Only Supreme Court and High Court. If government, central state governments are not able to understand the meaning of the particular law in the constitution, that time Supreme Court and High Courts have right or they have power to explain the meaning of that particular law to the government. So this is known as courts have power to interpret the constitution. Next one is there. Sources of revenue or income sources, okay, to run the government at central, state and local level government. Sources of income are specified in the constitution. Okay, in the constitution it is included that what are the types of sources of income or what type of taxes that government should collect from the people. All these things are clearly specified in the constitution. This is also one of the important feature of federalism. Okay, then federal countries, fifth, sixth one, sources of revenue are specified in the constitution. Okay, and next one, two aspects and dual objective. These are again features of federalism. Sources of income or sources of revenue to run the government efficiently, okay, are clearly specified in the constitution. And there are two aspects, mutual trust and agreement to live together. Mutual trust and agreement to live together is very important and essential feature of federalism. Because in democratic country, people are believing on each other, they have trust on each other. Okay, they have trust on each other, what they are saying or what they are following, what they are eating and dressing. If they have trust on each other, it is very beneficial for the country, okay, to develop the fraternity, to develop the brotherhood. Okay, and another aspect, agreement to live together. If we have trust on you, you should have trust on me. Okay, and both with both mutual trust, okay, we both have right, okay, to live together peacefully. So these are two aspects of federalism or federal countries. And there are dual objective, okay, they are country should protect the our country, okay, from various perspectives. Okay, and at the same time it accommodated regional diversity. Country should protect from outside forces, okay, and at the same time there should be accommodation of regional diversity. Okay, to strengthen the unity of the country, federal countries have dual objective to strengthen the unity of the country, okay, by seeing the outside forces whether they are active or not, okay, means to protect the country's border from outside forces and maintain the unity of the country. At the same time, country should also work to accommodate regional diversity. Regional diversity means what? Dear students, you might have already studied that India is one of the country in the world, okay, which has immense and a very variety of diversity. Okay, this diversity is also considered a plus point because diversity makes the unity of the country, and that is why it is the duty of government, it is the duty of citizens of the country to protect and maintain and accommodate this diversity systematically. because we, in India there are many people who follows different customs, traditions, culture, religion, languages, okay, festivals, eating style, dressing style, everything is different from our country, and therefore this diversity can also makes our country a unique country in the world. Okay, so federal countries has a dual objective, that is to strengthen the unity of the country, to make the country powerful, okay, and at the same time to accommodate regional diversity. यानी country में जो regional diversity है, country में जो अलग अलग type के लोग हैं, अलग अलग type की languages बोलते हैं, अलग अलग type के foods हैं, उनके food style है, costume style से, उनके religion, caste and sex, everything are different. ओके, तो उसको मेंटेन करना ये हमारी एज वेल एज गवर्नमेंट की भी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है. सो दीज आर फीचर्स ऑफ फेडरलिज्म. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप दैट यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस पर्टिकुलर पार्ट ऑफ फेडरलिज्म, ओके, विच इज क्वाइट इसेंशियल फॉर द डेमोक्रेटिक सेटअप ऑफ द कंट्री. सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड ऑल दिस थिंग्स. कीप रीडिंग, एंड इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन you ask me freely, okay, we'll meet tomorrow with another topic of this same lesson of federalism. So thank you.